माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन आफ्टर दिवाली वेकेशन. आफ्टर दिवाली वेकेशन दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर विच वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टूडे. बिफोर गोइंग ऑन वेकेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड अवर फिफ्थ चैप्टर दैट इज फ्रैक्शन एंड वी हैव लर्न सम कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन दिस चैप्टर. टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वन ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ दैट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर दैट इज मोर ऑन कंपेरिजन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन. See, if you remember, before vacation, we have learned this concept, comparison of fraction, right? But we have learned the comparison of fractions having either same denominator or same numerator. That means we have learned comparison of like this fraction, 2 by 5, 3 by 5. Means either having same denominator or another type of comparison we have learned, that is 1 by 7 and 1 by 9, means having same numerator. We have learned the comparison of fraction having either same denominators or same numerators. Okay, but today we are going to learn such a comparison of fraction whose denominators as well as numerators are totally different. So in that case, how to compare these two fractions, that we are going to learn today. Before that, let us revise. If denominators are same, then which fraction is greater? If denominators are same, now see here 2 by 5 and 3 by 5. Denominators are same. So in this between these two fractions, which one is greater? It is very simple. When denominators are same, the fraction having greater numerator is the greater fraction. Simple. When denominators are same, fraction having greater numerator is the greater fraction. That means 2 by 5 is less than the 3 by 5. Okay? Whereas when numerators are same, in that case, how to compare? When numerators are same, in that case, the fraction having less denominator is the greatest fraction actually. Means what? Here see 1 by 7 and 1 by 9. Which one is greater? This 1 by 7 is having smaller denominator. So this 1 out of 7 and 1 out of 9, this 1 out of 7 is greater. Understood? These two rules of comparison we have learned before going on vacation. Now, see here, if you'll observe these fractions 2 by 5, 3 by 7, 4 by 9 and 3 by 8, 5 by 7 and 7 by 8, if all these examples, if you'll observe, you'll come to know that the given two fractions are totally different, means their numerators or denominators are not same. So in that case, how to multiply, how to compare them? Let's see. It's very easy. Just pay attention carefully. What to do? See, if you remember, while checking equivalency of fraction, whether given two fractions are equivalent or not, what we have done, we used cross multiplication method, right? So same method we are going to use here. Cross multiplication method. Cross multiplication method, how it is or what? How to do that? See, cross multiplication method says multiply numerator of first fraction with the denominator of second fraction, and on the other side multiply denominator of the first fraction with the numerator of second fraction. Okay, two sides are there, left hand side and right hand side. Okay, so on the left hand side, take numerator of first fraction, that is 2, multiply with the denominator of the second fraction. This should be on the left side. Okay, and denominator of first fraction, I'll put box here, denominator of first fraction multiply with the numerator of second fraction. Understood this step? Cross multiplication method. Numerator of the first fraction, denominator of the second fraction. And on the right hand side, denominator of the first fraction multiply with the numerator of the second fraction. Okay? Let's multiply. 7 2s are 14. Box, why I am putting box here? To put that sign. 5 threes are 15. Okay, now there are two sides. On the left hand side we have multiplication 14, and on the right hand side we have product 15. Okay, which is greater, 14 or 15? Compare these two products, 14 and 15, which is greater? 15. That means 14 is less than the 15. 14 is less than the 15. Okay, now 14, this 14 is on the left, is on the left hand side. Okay, so the fraction which is on the left hand side, take that here, means 2 upon 5 is on the left hand side. So take it here, and the fraction which is on the right side, take this here. So since here product on the right hand side, product on the right hand side is greater, that means the fraction on the right hand side is greater. So 2 upon 5 is less than the 3 upon 7. 3 upon 7 is greater than the 2 upon 5. Okay? So in this way we have to compare the two fractions whose numerators and denominators are totally different. Okay? We have to use here cross multiplication method. Next, see here. 4 upon 9, 3 upon 8. Both the numerators and denominators are different. So you, let's use cross multiplication method. Okay, see here. Numerator of the first fraction, denominator of the second fraction, that is 4 multiply with the 8 and 9 multiply with the 3. 8 fours are 32, whereas 9 threes are 27. So if you'll observe these two products, 32 is greater than 27. So 32 is greater than 27. So 32 means the product on the left side. Okay. So which fraction is on the left side? 4 upon 9. And here 3 by 8. So left side product is greater. That means left side fraction is greater. 4 upon 9 is greater than the 3 upon 8. Understood? Next. 5 upon 7 and 7 upon 8. Both the numerators and denominators are different. Let's use cross multiplication method to compare. 5 into 8. Box, 7 into 7. 8 fives are 40. Box, 7 sevens are 49. So now see here, between 40 and 49, which is greater? 49. That means 40 is less than 49. Do you know? This sign is called greater than. This sign is called less than, and this sign is called is equal to. Okay? So see here, 40 is less than 49. That means the fraction on this side, 5 upon 7, is less than 7 upon 8. Okay? Next, 9 upon 13, 3 upon 7. Let's see. 9 multiply with the 7 and 13 multiply with 3. 9 sevens are 63 and 13 threes are 39. So 63 is greater than 39. That means the fraction on the left side, 9 upon 13, is greater than the 3 upon 7. Okay? So in this way we have to compare the two fractions whose numerators and denominators both are different. Okay, the three types of comparison we have learned along with this. The comparison of fraction having same denominators, the comparison of fraction having same numerators, and the comparison of fraction having different denominators and numerators. Okay, so all these three comparison understand clearly. If you have doubt in this, you can ask. In this practice 5.8, there are two more examples, 5th and 6th one. practice those two examples by yourself. Solve those examples by yourself. Okay. So hope you have understood this concept. Any doubt if you have in this, immediately ask me and clear that. Okay. So thank you and have a nice day.